fasten your seatbelt. With David Pogue, we're taking off on a voyage to the future.
I'm in a chase plane high over Lake Champlain in Vermont to observe one of the world's first electric airplanes. And I do mean chase plane.
I can't even keep up with him. I'm full power and he's walking away from me.
Our pilot is Chris Caputo.
Come on, man, step on it.
I can't do anything else, David. I don't have afterburner.
For years, you've been able to watch cool-looking electric plane videos on YouTube, created by some of the 300 companies who are working on them. But Beta Technologies in Burlington, Vermont is unique.
I believe we're the only company flying people.
Kyle Clark is Beta's CEO and founder. Its electric plane can carry 6 people and flies 250 miles on one charge.
But every year, batteries get better and better, about 7% per year. That means in 7 years, we'll double that. In another 7 years, we'll double that again.
So you think before you and I die that we will fly on an electric-powered jetliner?
Yes, absolutely.
Traditional airplanes pump out about 1 billion tons of carbon dioxide every year. Electric planes produce no emissions at all, and that's only their first advantage.
One of the things that I think is underappreciated in electric aviation is that it's quiet. You can actually hear the wind noise over the fuselage. You feel like a bird.
Electric motors are much simpler than jet engines, too. They contain a tenth as many parts. Furthermore, electric planes cost far less to fly, since electricity costs only about a 40th as much as jet fuel. But maybe the most impressive advantage of electric planes is that they can do this.
Wow.
These planes are known in the biz as eVTOLs, a clumsy acronym for Electric Vertical Takeoff and Landing. They don't need a runway to take off, but they can still fly forward the usual way.
The propellers on the front are used in both forms of flight. In the hover portion of the flight, they're tilted up. The 6 propellers in the back are just used in the lifting portion of the flight, so the hover portion of the flight.
Adam Goldstein is the founder and CEO of Archer Aviation, an eVTOL company in San Jose, California, devoted to creating air taxis. You'll board the air taxi from a so-called vertiport downtown, and then fly to the airport, for example, to catch your traditional flight. Goldstein says your eVTOL flight will cost about as much as an Uber or Lyft ride.
There's lots of traffic that will congest the roads in between the city centers and those airports.
Yeah.
Manhattan to a JFK is a great example where it's actually not that far on the ground, but takes a really long time using ground transportation.
Well, this sounds great. Planes that are faster, safer, cheaper, more reliable, and better for the environment. So what's the holdup?
You're talking about a class of airplanes that did not exist.
Aerospace consultant Sergio Chicuta can tell you what the last hurdle is, the Federal Aviation Administration.
The FAA is a very complex task. They make sure that we can walk onto one of the planes and be in no more danger than getting out of bed.
The need for FAA approval explains 2 strange aspects of Beta's plane. First, it's available with or without its vertical propellers. Clark believes that it will be easier to get initial FAA approval for a traditional plane than one that takes off vertically. As for the second strange thing, Beta's goal isn't creating air taxis.
There are a lot of ways that we can make a meaningful dent on the emissions of aviation before we start to do the thing that everybody talks about, jumping over traffic.
Yeah.
Moving cargo, moving medical, all of those things happen first.
Really? The world's first electric planes will make history by carrying boxes?
Let's point out, cargo room.
Yes.
For consultant Chicuta, that makes perfect sense.
All the way back there.
Exactly.
One of the goals from Amazon is to have the majority of their products to be available the same day in large metropolitan areas. What if I can actually take off and land from one warehouse to the other warehouse and move this cargo? I always think of the Beta airplane as the Amazon truck with wings.
Today, every airline has a desperate pilot shortage. That's one reason that most eVTOLs will eventually be self-flying.
In the 2030s, 2040s, there's going to be a very good chance that you're going to walk into an airplane where there's no pilot.
But in the near term, the FAA will require a pilot.
So with your left hand, just slowly pick up the lift lever.
Oh, I can actually feel vibration.
The aircraft's going to lift off the ground.
Fortunately, flying these planes isn't rocket science, as Beta pilot Chris Caputo showed me in Beta's simulator.
Can we fly over the lake?
Absolutely. So now what we're going to do is we're going to transition onto the wing of the plane.
Oh, okay.
Just push forward with your right hand a little bit, a little forward pressure. So now we're just flying on the wing of the plane. We're literally just sipping energy.
After 20 simulated minutes flying over simulated Lake Champlain, it was time to simulated land.
Touchdown. Thank you for flying Air Pogue.
You're very welcome.
We know that you have a choice when it comes to electric aircraft. Actually, you don't.
Beta and Archer have received millions of dollars worth of orders from various airlines and military branches. Both of them, plus an air taxi company called Joby, have already delivered some planes to the Air Force. All three companies expect to receive FAA approval and begin flying in the U.S. next year. On the day of our visit, Beta Technologies unveiled its new factory, the first electric plane plant outside of China. Among the dignitaries in attendance, Vermont Senator Bernie Sanders.
So it is an extraordinary day, not just for Vermont or for the country, but I think for aviation and in taking on climate change as well.
Why Vermont? It seems like all the engineers and the programmers are in Silicon Valley.
In Vermont, there's a heavy awareness of climate change. And having a group of people working on this that not only are really good at what they do, but they care about the mission, gives them a little extra oomph at 2 a.m. when we're trying to get ready for a flight test the next morning.
We are cleared to land.
Among those passionate Vermont employees, former Delta pilot Chris Caputo.
I haven't flown this aircraft in a while, so don't judge my landing too much, guys.
Did you take a pay cut to come here?
I did. A pretty healthy pay cut. But it's more about the mission that this company is on to decarbonize aviation and do something good for our planet, our country, and the world, and you know, your kids, my kids, and the next generation.